mama, she killing it. Yo, nigga gon' have to write a will. Oh. Why are and don't respect me love with Benjamin Franklin. Okay. I got that white like Pee Wee Herman. Yo. Got green like.
Great news! I did some back-to-school shopping today with my best friend, except it wasn't your traditional back-to-school shopping, if you know what I mean. This beautiful fluorite tower. Fluorite is great for reducing negative energy, aiding in logic and learning, which is perfect for any witch that is going to school. Second thing I bought was this little tiny obsidian, which is great for protection. It can slip into any pocket. I just thought I would need it when I'm going to school. I bought this sage cleansing spray. Also, I really like it because I enjoy having an on-the-go method of cleansing, especially when I get into spaces that I'm uncomfortable in or that I don't like the energy in. I also bought this cute little pentacle necklace so that everybody at my university knows I'm a witch in case they weren't sure. The last thing I bought was this little tiny jar to turn into a spell jar so that I could wear it and take it with me everywhere, and I am in love with it. Okay, that's all. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Hey, what y'all get for number 12?
I got 18.
Oh, I got 9.5.
I got Abraham Lincoln for some reason.
Me and my friends manifesting that we'll get straight A's on our report card knowing dang well we all have about 27 missing assignments.
Let's talk the best crystals to bring with you to school. This is part one, where I'm going to focus on academics. In part two, coming soon, I'll talk more about the social aspect. My number one recommendation for crystals to bring to school is going to be Tiger's Eye. It's incredibly grounding, it helps with focus, it also helps with courage and self-confidence, which will help you with presentations or even just speaking up on a Zoom call. Number two recommendation is going to be Obsidian. It's also grounding, it also helps with focus, but it also wards off negative energies, which will help you stay focused on your schoolwork. Number three is a great one for tests, and that's Amethyst. It heightens your intuition, it promotes clearer thinking, and it'll also help you focus. Number four is Howlite. It's another one that's really grounding. It's also just got a really calming energy that'll help you brush off drama and focus on class. Let me know if there's any energies in particular you want to see in part two. Have a great day, bye!
You have simply forgot what you signed, oh honestly. Did you not read the colony policy that defined you as company property? That wavered your say in autonomy. The conglomerates got you in lock and key. We put
Witchcraft during the school year, part one. Take a witchy shower either at the beginning or the end of the day to cleanse yourself. Pick soaps with ingredients that correspond to your intention. Bless your soap. Visualize negativity running down the drain. You can also smoke cleanse afterwards.
Witchy, should I send my kids to school with? Self-love spell jar. Protection spray. Anti-anxiety oil. Rose quartz. Citrine. Tiger's eye.
I'm saving the harder ones for last because usually people don't want to do it. Me included. This could be considered general, even if we're not like witchy, but I'm telling you, if your body's going to be so sensitive to energy and you are going to be sensitive to energies, especially going into a public space, then you're going to need your body in check. What do I mean by that? Well, getting your sleep schedule done, making sure that you're setting a goal to get your homework done. Because you don't need that stress. If you have that stress, how are you going to be able to comprehend any energies that are entering you and be able to filter that confidently? Your body is the vessel. It's going to need rest. So this is just a general fucking statement. Make sure that you have your body rested up. Make sure that you're sleeping. Make sure that you're getting your shit done. And any hobbies that you want to do, schedule time for that. Schedule happiness time. It's kind of sad that capitalism makes me have to call it that. But you know what I mean. And also, remember, you have a choice. Don't sign up for shit you don't want to do.
Since a lot of us are going back to school, I made you guys a spell perfect to do at the beginning of the year for good grades and stress release. good grade spell. Cleanse. Cinnamon. Rosemary. Himalayan salt. Bay leaf with intention. Then burned. Seal with red or white. Candle wax. Witchy school tips. Tip 1. Draw pentagrams on your papers for protection. Tip 2. Color code your pens with your intentions. I'm using white here since it can replace most colors. Cleanse. Have crystals that protect or help with your focus. Oils that help focus. Cleanse all school books. Cleans jewelry after each day. Iron helps ward off pentagram negativity. In phone case. Charge and cleanse the crystals cover each night. Bags to keep things to enforce that intention, like red for gym, because that's the color that represents activity. Blessed be loves.
Every time we talk, it just hurts so bad. Cause I don't even know what we are. I don't even know where to start. But I can play the part. We say we're friends, but I'm catching you across the room. It makes no sense, cause we're fighting over what we do. And there's no way that I'll end up being with you. But friends don't look at friends that way.
Okay. What the fuck?
I'm playing.
Okay.
You are Elastigirl.
Oh my God.
Pull yourself together.
Sigils to write on your papers for school. Good grade sigil. Good luck sigil. Absorb knowledge sigil.
Into the thick of it. Into the thick of it. Ugh.
but we can't see where we're going.
Con las uñas te puedo arañar, cat, kitty, cat, cat, kitty, cat.